Joining us now, CNN political commentator Van Jones, CNN White House correspondent John Harwood, and CNN senior law enforcement analyst Andrew McCabe. He's the former deputy director of the FBI. And John, I just want to start with you on the breaking news, which is that Mick Mulvaney, former White House chief of staff, who up until a few minutes ago was the special envoy to Northern Ireland, he's quit. He says, I just can't do it based on what he saw yesterday. I'm out. He went on to say, we have the sound. I want to play some of the sound from what he said because it's fascinating. Listen.
I call Pompeo. I'm the special envoy to Northern Ireland, and it's a small job. It's a part-time gig, but it's all I've got in the administration. I called Mike Pompeo last night, left him a note, told him that I'd be resigning from that. I can't do it. I can't stay. It's a nothing thing. It doesn't affect the outcome. It doesn't affect the transition, but it's what I've got, right? And it's a position I really enjoy doing, but you can't do it. And I wouldn't be surprised to see more of my friends resign over the course of the next 24 to 48 hours.
He says he's not surprised to hear talk about the 25th Amendment, John. He says he's not surprised that members of the House were talking about impeachment yesterday. What he was most surprised about was the fact that they went home without debating impeachment on the floor because he doesn't think anything should be off the table. That's from the president's former chief of staff, John.
Well, right. But I got to tell you, that sounds to me like a bit of a joke. You know, Allison was talking a few moments ago about how the stain doesn't wash off. For Mick Mulvaney to announce at this stage, 13 days left in the presidency, this kind of nothing job that he has, and make a big to-do about how I'm resigning now in protest, that is an attempt to cleanse his reputation. Let's just remember, Mick Mulvaney is the guy who sat on the stage when he was White House Chief of Staff at the Conservative Political Action Committee and talked about the coronavirus as the latest Democratic hoax to bring down the president. We are now at the end of, at the beginning of 2021, and 350,000 Americans have been killed. This pandemic is raging. He understands the nature of Donald Trump. Everyone in that White House has understood the nature of Donald Trump. What is happening now is that it is becoming more and more obvious to more and more people. It's been clear for a while that the president of the United States is mentally ill, that he does not recognize and is not capable of acting upon the difference between truth and lies, between right and wrong. And to the extent that people actually still have influence and power in the White House, which Mick Mulvaney does not, I'm not sure it does anyone any good except those individuals for them to resign, because for 13 days left, if in fact their conscience is triggered by what they're seeing, better for the United States of America for them to stay and try to stop bad things from happening than to raise their hand and say, I out of my sense of morality, I am quitting this job with 13 days to go.
Andrew McCabe, you remember the beginning of the Trump presidency, of course. You were in the FBI. It began with American carnage. It began with the president at his inauguration describing his worldview, the way he saw America, as American carnage. And it was bound to end this way. It ends with American carnage. It ends with an armed insurrection. And if you just tracked the rhetoric all along and the actions, of course it was bound to end this way. This isn't a surprise. Yes, it was a shock yesterday, a huge shock to see it, but it wasn't surprising. This is what he's called for. How do you see it as a law enforcement mind?
You know, Allison, I remember that day. I remember that statement during his speech on his own inauguration like it was yesterday. I sat in a darkened and pretty much empty J. Edgar Hoover building, my office overlooking Pennsylvania Avenue, and heard him utter those words. And to see yesterday, those words were a prediction of what he would render in this country. I've spent countless hours of my career working with people like the Capitol Police Department and MPD to protect our monuments to democracy, to protect our national monuments, to protect the Capitol. I was involved in, oversaw the FBI role in the President Obama's first inauguration, countless State of the Union operations, national security special events. To see that Capitol overrun by a mob of domestic terrorists, and that is absolutely what they are, is sickening. It's absolutely repulsive, and this president should be held responsible for that. He is responsible for it, and the Congress should take that up in an impeachment inquiry and vote immediately.